Hi, I'm Ryan at Marine Parts Source, and in this video, I'd like to discuss how to correctly measure a steering cable on your boat. Now, steering cables are one of the most returned items we get at Marine Parts Source, and one of the big reasons why is because people often measure them incorrectly, and it can be a real hassle to return a cable because getting it back in the packaging can be difficult, particularly when it's a longer cable. And of course, there's extra cost involved in that and time as well. So by measuring it correctly, you can get it right the first time and you can avoid all of those problems. Now, a lot of people make the mistake of measuring a cable from end to end, you know, from the metal end over here to the end of the cable on this side. That's incorrect. If you're measuring a control cable or a shift cable, that is how you measure it. But with steering cables, it's different. Now, you can save yourself a lot of time and headache and not even have to measure the cable if you find the part number on the cable jacket itself. So to save some time and effort of measuring the cable, you can find the number on the jacket to tell you the length of the cable. You can see the part number here. No matter which brand you have, the part number is going to be pretty similar in that there's going to be some sort of letter combination first that's usually indicating what brand of cable it is. Then there'll be some numbers that indicate what series of cable, and then the last couple of digits are usually the length of cable in feet. Some older cables that are made by Morse actually have the length in inches instead of feet. In this case, you'll see that we've got a steering cable from SeaStar Solutions, which is the same as Dometic. It's a 62 series, which is a rotary cable, and the last two digits indicate that this is a 10-foot cable in length. Now, in a lot of cases, the number on the jacket is no longer there. It's worn off over time, or it's really hard to read. In that case, you're gonna have to get the tape measure out and measure the cable manually. One of the biggest mistakes that people make when measuring steering cables is they'll measure it from end to end. This is actually not correct. What you want to measure on rotary and rack and pinion cables is going to be just the plastic jacket of the cable. So you're going to start from where the metal hardware ends on one side and just go to the metal hardware on the other side, and that's it. Once you have that measurement, you can move on to the next step. So once you have the measurement for the plastic jacket of the cable, there's actually a formula that you'll use to calculate what length of cable that you order. But it varies depending on what style of cable that you have. If you have a rotary cable like I have here, you're going to add 18 inches to the measurement that you took and then round up to the next foot. And that'll be the length of cable that you actually order. Now, if you have a rack and pinion style cable, you're going to add 30 inches to the length that you took and then round that up to the next foot. That'll be what you order. Now, some people out there are going to have a jet boat steering cable. In that case, the method is actually completely different. You're going to actually measure the cable from end to end, and then you'll just round it up to the next foot. That's the length that you'll want to order for the jet boat cables. If you need help identifying which style of cable you have on your boat, we created a video on how to do that. You can find the link to it in the description of this video. And if you have any other questions about how to identify your cable or to measure it correctly, feel free to give us a call at 866-388-0390, or you can visit us online at marineparksource.com. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe to this channel, and find us on Facebook and like and subscribe to us there as well.